So from today we will start the design of the toe slab. So for designing of the toe slab, as you can see over here, this is nothing but the height of the base slab, that is 0.55, and this due to the soil, due to the base slab it is 0.55, and due to the soil it is 0.95. Now total is of 1, but due to the soil we are going to assume it as 0.95. Then you need to calculate these pressures. Already you had calculated yesterday. So pressures at point D is 124.54 kilonewton per meter square, and at this particular point it is 116.67 kilonewton per meter square. Now you need to calculate the total downward pressure. So for calculating the downward pressure, first of all you will calculate due to the soil. So when you are going to calculate it with the purpose of the soil, due to the soil, at that time you need to consider the unit weight of the soil, that is 17. So 0.95 into 17, you will get it as 16.15. And due to the toe slab, you have to consider the density, that is 25. So 0.55 into 25, you will get it as 13.75 kilonewton per meter square. And the total downward pressure comes up to be 29.9 kilonewton per meter square. So first of all, complete up till here. Then we'll proceed further for calculating the net pressures at point C and net pressure at point D. And after completing, let me know. Okay, done. All of you had completed up till here. Should I proceed further for the net pressures at point A and net pressures at point B? Okay. So for calculating the net pressure at point A, or C, the total downward pressure kitna tha? 29.9. So total downward pressure, that is 29.9 minus the pressure at point C, that is 116.67. So aapko net pressure at point C milta hai 86.77, that will be negative, that is 86.77 kilonewton per meter square. Then again you need to calculate the net pressure at point D. So net pressure at point D calculate karne ke liye again you are having the total downward pressure, that is 29.9 minus the pressure at point D, that is 124.54. So aapko net pressure at point D milta hai, again negative, so going upward, that is 94.64 kilonewton per meter square. So calculate the net pressures at point C and point D. After completing this much, let me know. See whether you are also getting the same answers or not. Yes, done. Everyone had completed up till here. Yes, all of you had completed. Everyone had got the answers for net pressure at point C and D. Yes, Omkar. Should I proceed with the resultant force? Okay. So now for calculating the resultant force per meter width, you need to add both the pressures, that is the pressure at point C and pressure at point D, that is 86.77 plus 94.64 divided by 2 into width, that is 2.1 into per meter width we are going to consider, that is 1. So total resultant force aapko milta hai 190.48. Then you need to calculate x bar. So for calculating x bar calculate karne ke liye again you need to use the two pressures that you had calculated earlier, that is 86.77 plus 2 into b, that is it should be here 94.64, not 294. So do that correction. So it should be 94.64 upon 86.77 plus 94.44 into again 2.1 by 3. So you will get the value of x bar, that is 1.065 meter. Then after calculating resultant and x bar, you need to calculate the factor movement. So factor movement calculate karne ke liye, you need to multiply the resultant and x bar by 1.5. So aapko factor movement milti hai 304.29 kilonewton meter. First of all, complete up till here. Then we'll proceed for the AST calculations. After completing, let me know. is done. All of you had completed up till here. यस हो गया यहाँ तक के सबका. यस रीदा कंप्लीटेड. एवरीवन हैड गॉट द वैल्यूज फॉर द फैक्टर मूवमेंट दैट इज एम यू 304.29 किलो न्यूटन मीटर. नाउ यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट डी इफेक्टिव डेप्थ. सो टोटल डेप्थ इज 550 माइनस कवर. सो यू विल गेट द डेप्थ दैट इज 490 mm. Then B is your 1000 mm. So उसपे से AHT required आप calculate कर सकते हो by using the formula 0.5 FCK by FY वाला. आपको AHT required मिलेगा 1868.72 mm². Then again for calculating AHT minimum, same formula that is 0.12% of V into D. So AHT minimum आपको मिलता है 660 mm². Then here you are going to use 16 mm diameter bar. So by using 16 mm 5 bars, spacing comes up to be 107.59 mm. So here you can provide 16 5 at the rate of 100 mm center to center at the bottom of the toe slab. So first of all, complete for the main reinforcement and we shall proceed for the distribution one. Is this Sony? Rename yourself properly. If you are Akash Sony, rename yourself properly. And if you are having any of the doubts, you can ask. Yes, all of you are done with the main reinforcement. All of you are completed up till here. Should I proceed with the distribution one? Is completed. Slightly increase your speed. हो गया सबका यहाँ तक के? Yes, Saurabh, Mehfooz, had you completed up till here? Okay. Then you should tell me after completing. सो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन रेनफोर्समेंट के लिए अगेन एएसटी मिनिमम विल बी 660 mm square. देन हियर आल्सो यू नीड टू प्रोवाइड द 10-5 डायमीटर बार. सो प्रोवाइड 10-5 एट द रेट ऑफ 100 mm सेंटर टू सेंटर एज द सेकेंडरी रेनफोर्समेंट. And also you can provide the 10-5 at the rate of 100 mm center to center on the both ways at the top of the toe slab. So here we have completed the design for the toe slab. Now we'll start with the design of the counter fort. We'll complete up till here, then we'll start with the design of the counter fort. And after completing, tell me. Is done, completed. Okay, complete it fast. I hope all the others are also completed. Now we'll start with the design of counter fort. Here we have completed the design of stem, heel slab as well as toe slab. Now we need to do the design of the counter fort. So for calculating the design of the counter fort, first of all, we are going to do for the tension reinforcement to resist the bending moment. So for tension reinforcement to resist the bending moment, this is a diagram. So as you can see in this diagram, this is your distance, that is 0.3, that is of the stem. Then this is your 3.9 meter remaining distance. And from here, we are going to calculate this distance, that is DC. So we are going to calculate in the further steps. And this total height is 8.45. And again, this distance is your 600 by 600. And these reinforcements also we are going to calculate in the further steps. So just draw this diagram. This we are going to do for the tension reinforcement to resist the bending moment. This is nothing but the counter fort. This is the counter force that you need to draw. It is in the 3D way. So this is nothing but the 0.3 meter, that is nothing but the distance. See the stability analysis diagram jo apne stem ka, that is jo apne part first construct kiya tha, that is this part, that is 0.3, and ye jo part hai, this is your second part, and this one here we had distributed in the two parts. So ye yahan se ye itna we need to calculate this distance, that is DC. So and this will be your 3.9 minus 0.3. total distance is your 3.9 and this will be 0.3. so this distance will be 3.9 minus 0.3 and this is the total height, that is 8.45, and the reinforcement we are going to calculate in the further steps. And this is nothing but the size that we had provided, that is of 600 by 600. This is your XX section. Again, these are the reinforcement that we need to provide. That is 8-5 at the rate of 175 mm center to center and 8-5 at the rate of 200 mm center to center. And this is again distance, that is 3.9 meter. And this is your 600. I hope now you understood. All of you are having the PDFs also with you. And this counterfort we need to design as a cantilever member only in order to resist the lateral earth pressure acting on the counterfort from the both the sides. Lateral earth pressure will act on the counterfort from both the sides. So for counterfort, you need to design the counterfort as a cantilever member only so that it can resist the lateral forces that are acting on both the sides on the counterfort. When we will solve further, the ideas will be more clear. For now, you can just draw this diagram. After completing the diagram, let me know so that we can proceed further. Yes, done up till here. Number of bars are here 4 at the rate of 25 millimeter diameter as a tension reinforcement. All these we are going to calculate in the further steps. After completing, please tell me. Yes, all of you had completed. Everybody had done up till here. Should I proceed further? Okay. What about others? All the others had also completed. So the counter fort, just make a note of this, that the counter fort will be designed as a cantilever member only in order to resist the lateral earth pressure acting on the counter fort from both the sides. The lateral earth pressure is acting upon the counter fort from both the sides so that it will be behaving as a cantilever member only. And the overall length of the counter fort is usually taken as 2 times the thickness of the stem. मतलब thickness stem की जो भी thickness है that will be taken as the overall 2 times the overall length of the counter fort. Whereas the width of the counter fort will be kept equal to the length of the counter fort unless specified. Length हमेशा आपको कितनी लेना है length of the counter fort आपको हमेशा 2 times लेना है थिकनेस ऑफ द स्टेम के मतलब जितनी भी थिकनेस ऑफ द स्टेम है यू हैव टू टेक मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 2 फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग द लेंथ और विड्थ आपको इक्वली रखना है अनलेस एंड अंटिल इट इज नॉट बीइंग स्पेसिफाइड इन द क्वेश्चन एंड द टोटल प्रेशर एक्टिंग ऑन वन काउंटर फोर्ट विल बी 47.88 ओनली दैट वी आर कैलकुलेटेड इन द वेरी प्रीवियस स्टेप सो द प्रेशर विल बी इक्वल ओनली दैट इज ऑफ 47.88. So just make a note of this, then we will calculate for the total lateral pressure. Yes, after completing, let me know. Okay, yahan tak hai sabka. Everybody had written this note. Okay. Now, you need to calculate the lateral pressure, total lateral pressure on the soil. So, for calculating the total lateral pressure on one counter fort, so the total pressure acting on one counter fort, एक counter fort पे act करने वाला pressure कितना है? 47.88 and 8.45 is nothing but the total height. As you can see over here, this 8.45 is nothing but the total height. So, this distance will be 8.45 divided by 3. Then the total lateral pressure on the soil. The total lateral pressure on the soil will be half into base into height. That is 1 by 2 into base. That is 47.88 into height. That is 8.45 into L by 2 into L by 2. Now what is L over here? L is nothing but the spacing that we had provided in the very previous step. तो स्पेसिंग हमने कितनी प्रोवाइड की थी सेंटर टू सेंटर स्पेसिंग बिटवीन द काउंटर फोर्ट दैट वी हैड प्रोवाइडेड इट एज 3 मीटर सो एल विल बी 3/2 + 3/2 सो टोटल लैटरल प्रेशर आपको मिलता है 606.879 किलो न्यूटन मीटर एंड आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग द टोटल लैटरल प्रेशर आपको क्या कैलकुलेट करता है फैक्टर मोमेंट सो फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग द फैक्टर मोमेंट यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई द इट बाय 1.5 So 1.5 into pressure into 8.45 by 3. So you will get the value of factor moment as 2564.06 kilonewton meter. So calculate the total lateral pressure on the soil as well as the factor bending moment. then we'll proceed further. And if any doubts in this, you can ask. I hope everyone understood up till here. Is completed up till here. So all of you are completed up till here. Should I proceed with the further steps? Everyone had got the value for the factor bending moment, that is 2564.06. Okay. Now you need to calculate the value for alpha. So for calculating the value of alpha, again proceed, see your diagram. So uspe se aapko tan alpha milega. Tan alpha is your 3.9 minus 0.3 upon 8.45. So, uspe se alpha ki value milegi 23.07. See the diagram. So, alpha will be your 23.07. And then cos alpha will be DC upon total distance, that is 300 plus 3900. माइनस कवर दैट इज 60. सो इस पे से आपको डीसी जो है डिस्टेंस उसकी वैल्यू मिलेगी आपको 3808.91 mm. देन आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग द वैल्यू फॉर डीसी एंड अल्फा यू कैन कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू फॉर एएसटी रिक्वायर्ड. सो एएसटी रिक्वायर्ड कैलकुलेट करने के लिए ऑलरेडी यू आर हैविंग द मोमेंट मोमेंट है आपके पास. जस्ट नाउ यू हैड कैलकुलेटेड द वैल्यू ऑफ मोमेंट, that is 2564.06 kilonewton meter. B is your 600 as given in the diagram. Then DC just now you had calculated. So DC aapka kitna aaya hai 3808.91. Uspe se aap AC required calculate kar sakte ho by using the formula 0.5 FCK by FY in bracket 1 minus under root of 1 minus 4.6 mu upon BD square FCK. Then, first of all, complete up till here, up till AST required. Then we shall proceed for the spacing and number of bars. See, check whether you are also getting the value of alpha same as I had got, that is 23.07. And we are having last 2 minutes. So those who are not given the attendance, give your attendance in the chat box. and rejoin the lecture again after 10 minutes. Calculate AST required in 10 minutes, then we will proceed further. I hope everyone understood up till here, and if any of the doubts you can ask.